Welcome everyone. I am Pramod Beesal, IIT Delhi graduate, and currently an RSME officer, IES 2017 batch. Today we are going to discuss about the robot kinematics, that is the forward kinematics as well as the reverse kinematics for 2 degree of freedom and 3 degree of freedom rotary system, because we just want to know the concept here and we will be taking up the simple concepts only, and mainly we will be focusing on geometrical analysis. Okay, so how, based upon the geometry or the geometrical analysis, how exactly do we do the forward kinematics or the reverse kinematics of a given system? Okay, so let's first discuss about what is a forward kinematics and what is a reverse kinematics. Fine. So let's say I have a robotic system here, of 2 degree of freedom robot system here. Okay, just for the understanding part, this is my link one. Okay. And then there is another link here, link 2. These two links are having two rotary joints here. Okay. Now, when I say that this link can have this motion possible, right? Okay. And this link can have this motion possible. And as we discussed in our notation part, and as we already know to some extent, that this will be given by this theta 1. So theta 1 is the rotation associated with the link 1. And theta 2 will be the rotation associated with link 2. Okay. So this is my theta 2. Okay. Theta in anti-clockwise direction we take as positive. Okay. Theta in anti-clockwise direction will be considered as positive for our analysis purpose. Okay. So if this is my end effector, right? And the end effector's coordinates are x, comma, y. Now, with the help of two links of length L1 and another link of length L2 and these two parameters, theta 1 and theta 2, I am able to finally have the position x, y, and the overall position of this link is phi. Okay, so phi is the overall position with respect to the horizontal base. Okay. And theta 1 and theta 2 are individually associated with these links, L1 and L2 as well. And xy is my final coordinate of the end effector. Now, when I say the forward or the reverse kinematics, I am basically going to have a convergence between the joint space and what we call as a world space. Okay, so what do I mean by joint space? Joint space means the coordinate system attached to the joints, to individual joints. So theta 1 and theta 2 are basically the properties of my joint space. Okay. And when I say world space means in terms of absolute coordinates. Okay. So if let's say this was my origin, okay, x and y, two dimensional only we will take for now. So these x and y coordinates are giving me the world space, or the absolute coordinates, I can say, absolute coordinates of end effector or the position of end effector. Now, whenever I want to know the world space with the help of joint space, okay, meaning I know theta 1 and theta 2, link lengths are anyways will be known always, and I want to calculate x, y and phi. So how can I calculate that? So that system is known as forward kinematics. Okay, so going from joint space to the world space is known as forward kinematics, or we also call it as direct kinematics. Okay, so this is also known as direct kinematics. But when I go in reverse direction meaning when I go from world space to joint space, so this particular thing means I know x, y and I know phi, and I want to know the value of theta 1 and theta 2 to orient my end effector in this position, what should be the theta 1 and what should be theta 2 in order to give the command. Okay, so I know the world space, but I want to calculate the joint space. So that is my reverse kinematics. Okay, or inverse kinematics. Okay, so that is the basic difference between the direct kinematics and reverse kinematics, or forward kinematics and inverse kinematics. Okay, but why exactly do I want to do this transformation? Why can't I work with theta 1 and theta 2? Why do I want these x and y? Okay, so the main purpose of having these x and y or the world space is to use the absolute coordinate system. Okay, okay, and to communicate with the external world. So the world space is basically to communicate with external world. To communicate with external world or robots. Okay, so whatever system that we are having in our machinery or in our plant, production shop, anywhere, we need this robot to be able to communicate with other devices, other robots. Okay, in order to do that, we need to give the position with respect to the absolute coordinates, and that will be done with the help of a forward kinematics. Okay, now in order to carry out the forward kinematics, the two approaches that are very common and very useful, one is the geometrical approach, which we are going to discuss here. The geometrical approach we will be taking up for 3 degrees of freedom as well as 2 degrees of freedom. Okay, and another one is DH forward kinematics, that is Dynamit Hartenberg forward kinematics, that we will take up later because it's a bit complex and a lengthy also, but important from the mains point of view. Okay, so now let's do this 2 degrees of freedom direct kinematics analysis. Okay, so 2 degrees of freedom forward kinematics. Okay, so when I say, or when I do a forward kinematic analysis for this one, so what I basically want to know, the value of x and y and phi in terms of x, y and phi, and I am already given theta 1, theta 2 and my link lengths will always be known to me. Okay, there is no way that I don't know the link lengths actually. Fine, in order to do that, now here I will say, and this is my system, right, this is theta 1, this is theta 2, and these are xy coordinates. So this length is basically x length and this length is basically y length. Okay, and L1, L2 I already know. If I can give them in terms of this whole length can be divided, or I can say that it can be subdivided into two parts, this plus this. Okay, similarly the horizontal length can be divided into two parts, this and this. Okay, and as we can see that if this is L1, this length will be L1 cos theta 1. Okay, and this length will be L1 sin theta 1, right, this vertical length, this length. This length is going to be L2 into cos of this whole angle, and that whole angle is theta 2 plus theta 1. Okay, because this is theta 1, right, so that is going to be L2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2, and this is going to be L2 sine of theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay, and whenever we are doing a kinematic analysis in a robot, we don't write as cos theta 1 or sine theta 1, we will simply say C1 and this will S1. So that will directly give us cos theta 1, this will simply sin theta 1. If somewhere it is written as C2, that means cos of theta 2. Okay, C12 will mean cos of theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay, it is not cos theta 1 into cos theta 2, it is cos of theta 1 plus theta 2. Similarly, S12 sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2, sin theta 1 plus 2. Okay, that sort of analysis, that sort of notation we use here. Okay, now I can very easily say that my x value is equal to this plus this, right, and L1 C1 plus L2 C12, and my y value is equal to L1 sin theta 1 plus L2 sin theta 1 theta 2, right. So that is my forward kinematics, right, and phi is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2. You know, if there is a question regarding forward kinematics, that is what we need to do, only this much. Okay, now in this itself, if I want to carry out the inverse kinematics or the reverse kinematics, so what will that mean? So that is a forward kinematic analysis. Okay, now I want to do the inverse kinematics analysis. Sorry, I want to do the inverse kinematic analysis. In inverse kinematic analysis, I already know x and y are given to me, and phi is given to me. What I want to know, theta 1 and theta 2. Always link lengths will be given and known. Okay, so there is no doubt about, there is no question of knowing the link lengths here. Fine, now how do I do that? One thing that I can do is, I will simply square them both sides, x square and y square. Okay, both sides squared, both sides added up, and then I can simply solve it. Okay. Another. Okay. So as I said, we are going to square the x and y and add that together. Okay. So x square plus y square can directly be given by this length. Okay. Or the square of this particular length. Right. That will give me x square and y square, because this height is y and this length is x. Right. So simple right triangle theorem. Right. So this length will be my, or I can say O, A and B. So OB, x square plus y square, is basically nothing but OB square here. Right. But I can write that in other terms also, or in other ways also. I want to know these angles, theta 1, and I wish to know theta 2. This is my theta 2 over here, right? These two angles I want to know. So I can say that square, if this point is, let's say, O dash, then square of this length plus square of this length, right? So same OB square is equal to O dash B square plus O dash square, right? And O dash B, I already know that O dash B is nothing but L2 sine theta, right? L2 sine theta. So L2 sine theta 2 square plus OO dash. OO dash means this length, and this length is equal to L1 plus L2 cos theta, right? So L1 plus L2 cos theta square. Cos theta 2 square, right? Now I can simply expand it, okay? And expansion will give me L2 square, S2 square plus A square plus B square plus 2ABC2, right? That is my equal to X square plus Y square. And this L2 is 2 square and L2 C2 square, that is giving me L square, simply, right? So the only term that I am remaining with is 2L1 L2 C2 is equal to nothing but X square plus Y square minus L1 square minus L2 square, okay? And C2, or my cos of theta 2, is equal to x square plus y square minus L1 square minus L2 square divided by 2L1 L2. And that is the final answer that I will be having for cos theta 2. Okay, now I simply can take a cos inverse here and I can get the theta 2 value from here. Okay, theta 2 value I can get. Similarly, when I know phi, so theta 1 will be equal to phi minus theta 2, and that will give me my final answer. Now there is a catch here, and the catch is that inverse kinematics may not have a unique solution. Okay, so inverse kinematics may not have a unique solution. What do we mean by that? That it cannot have a, it may not have a unique solution, is that the only thing that we needed was this position at the end, right? And I can have this position in two configuration possible. One would be this sort of configuration, okay, and another would be this sort of configuration. Both link lengths are same, L1 and L2, but two configurations are possible here. Means I will be getting two solutions to get this x and y. That is why usually we define, whenever we are programming, we will define that we want a under solution or a above solution. Usually that has to be given. Okay, so this may also be asked that inverse kinematics have unique solution or not, so we can write that. Okay, so that is about the forward and reverse kinematics of a 2 degrees of freedom. 3 degrees of freedom, the forward kinematics as well as inverse kinematics with all rotary joints. Okay, so basically the problem that we are having here is there is a rotary joint, joint 1, okay, there is a link over here, then there is another link, rotary joint, and then there is a third link. This is my end effector here, okay? And all the things that I'm having over here, the coordinates, let's assume this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, and this is x3, y3. Link lengths are L1, L2, and L3. Finally, I want to calculate my x3 and y3, given that the joint parameters in a theta 1, second one theta 2, and third one theta 3, I already have them. So I need to calculate this length, which is x3, and this length, which is Y3. Okay. So in order to do the forward kinematics, I can do it very simply using the geometrical relationships here. Okay. So X value means this total length can be divided into three lengths here. Okay. So this length plus this length plus this one. Okay. Similarly, Y can also be divided into three parts plus this one. Okay. So all these lengths we can write as L1 cos theta 1, L2 C1 2, L3 C1 2 3, L1 S1, L2 S2, and L3 S1 2 3. Right? We can write them in this way. And simple geometrical trigonometrical transformations. Okay, so my x3 will be equal to l1 c1 plus l2 c1 2 plus l3 c1 2 3, and my y3 will be equal to l1 s1 plus l2 s1 2 plus l3 s1 2 3. Right, that is how I can do the forward kinematics here. One more thing I can calculate is phi is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3, or simply 1 2 3. Right. That also I can calculate. So that is all about the forward kinematics. Now if I look at the inverse kinematics of this same system here, okay. So in order to do the inverse kinematics here, means I will be given x3, y3, l1, l2, l3 and phi. All these values I am given, and I need to calculate theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3 over here. Okay, what will be those values? So when I try to solve this equation, the first thing is I try to write x2 y2 in terms of x3 y3 and in terms of lengths, all the link lengths. Okay, so I can say the very first equation is that x2 is equal to x3 minus l3 cos of phi. Okay, because phi is nothing but theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. Okay, or phi is our this angle. This total angle is phi. Okay, the total end effector angle we are having here is phi value. So phi is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. X2 value can be written in terms of x3, because x3 we already know. That's why we are writing it in this way. Y2 will be equal to y3 minus l3 sin phi. Okay, now using these two equations, we can now apply the same analysis as we did for 2 degrees of freedom, and that will give me simply this desired relationship, which is cos of theta 2 is equal to x2 square plus y2 square minus l1 square minus l2 square divided by 2 l1 l2. Okay, because I already know x2 value and y2 value, I can now apply this one. Okay, another format to write x2 and y2 will be that I can say x2 is equal to l1 c1 plus L2 C1 2. Right? X2 value is equal to L1 C1 plus L2 C1 2. Similarly, Y2 is equal to L1 S1 plus L2 S1 2. Okay? So these two equations I am going to use here. Y2 is equal to L1 S1 plus L2 S1 2. Now, expanding this one, it will give me, I will finally get. So I will apply the formula of C1 2 here. I will apply the formula of S1 2 here. Okay? And I can get x2 is equal to, taking cos theta 1 common, c1 into l1 plus l2 c2 minus s1 into l2 s2. Okay, at the same time y2 will be equal to c1 into l2 s2 plus s1 into l1 plus l2 c2. Okay, this is just the expansion of these cos terms and sine terms, and then I am taking cos theta 1 common, sin theta 1 here, cos theta 1 here, and sin theta 1 common. Okay, now I am having two equations and two unknown, cos theta 1 and sin theta 1, so I can solve it for them. Okay, so what I will get here is cos theta 1 is equal to l1 plus l2 c2 into x2 plus l2 s2 y2 divided by x2 square plus y2 square, and similarly s1 will be equal to l1 plus l2 c2 multiplied by y2 minus l2 s2 x2 divided by x2 square plus y2 square. You may try to solve these equations on your own so that you can get a better idea of it. Okay, now I can define tan theta 1 is equal to sin theta 1 upon cos theta 1. Okay, and that will give me theta 1 is equal to tan inverse of sin theta 1 divided by cos theta 1. I am having already these expressions with me, right? So I can calculate the value of theta 1 from here. So I have calculated finally theta 1, I have calculated theta 2, and theta 3 will be equal to 5 minus theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay, so that's how I can calculate all the angles here, and that is the complete inverse kinematics for 3 degrees of freedom. Okay, so finally we have seen in the forward and inverse kinematics for 2 degrees of freedom and 3 degrees of freedom. That's it for this particular video. And this was geometrical analysis. For our dimmed inward DH analysis, we are going to have a separate video. And there again, we will solve these same configurations. Okay. Well, thank you for watching the video and best of luck.